Yep. So let's start the session now. So there is no resort today. He would take some time. Yeah, he isn't present. Right. So yesterday there was a question like, if a single IP is given on two PCs, first they will not allow. Okay, let me do one thing. I'll just show you this on our lab. You can understand this more better. The term we call it as IP conflict. Good, but the thing is, how?
And the half row of data is sent to the another
system.
And then after it, so the error. So it is not possible to.
How it is happening? It is showing like IP conflict,
yeah.
Right? How it is knowing that on the other device we have given the IP?
It is using a protocol.
What is a protocol? So let me show you the let me tell you the procedure, then we'll see the thing. Okay, so what actually happens is, when we are having two PCs or two devices, okay, connected together or connected to a switch, whatever the thing, if they are connected somehow, and if you are giving the IP 10.0.0.1, the same IP on 10.0.0.1 on the other PC, okay, the procedure is, whenever you have given an IP on one device, at whatever the point of time, on whatever the device which is using IP, it will generate gratuitous R. Gratuitous R. So it is one type of R used by devices in order to check the duplicacy of the IP. Okay. So immediately, as soon as you have given an IP on the device, it will check the device, whether other devices in my network, are they having the same IP? Any one of them are having the same IP or not? Okay. What is the need to check? What is the need to check? Okay. Ma'am. Okay. She's taking attendance in the class. There are two bubbles in the class. Okay, Bablu Mishra is one, and Bablu Gandhi is one. Okay, no, it is a very good name, should not spoil this. Not Gandhi, whatever the thing, Mishra, Yadav, Kuch. Yeah, Bablu Singh Yadav, whatever. Okay, so final output is, two Bablus are there in the class. Okay, ma'am will call Bablu. Which one should respond? Which bubble should respond to the attendance?
Both
of them. Okay. But the ma'am will make the mark for only one bubble. How will she know that that bubble has come today? Okay. First, madam has to differentiate, right? Both bubbles. So she will use bubble Mishra, bubble Yadav. Okay. Same thing happens when you are having two devices with same IP. When they are connected with a switch or something to some network, and if someone wants to speak to 10.1, devices, they don't know the PCs. They only know IPs. They only know IPs. If this PC 10.2 wants to speak to 10.1, he will just generate a request on the 10.1, not request on the 10.1. He will respond and he will respond. Yeah. Which one will it take? It will be confused. But to avoid this type of errors, we call it as IP conflicts. IP conflicts. To avoid this IP conflicts, we use, or the devices use, gratuitous R. That is the purpose of checking whether the IP assigned on me, is it the duplicated one or the unique one on my own. Okay, the process is, this PC, it has been assigned with 10.0.0.1 and it is connected to some network and it is having some IPs or devices or whatever. Okay, so immediately an IP is assigned, as an IP assigned on the device, it will generate a gratuitous R request. Gratuitous R request.
But sir, the same IP is possible in LAN.
In LAN?
Yes,
no. It will not be possible. There are some different cases where we can use it. I'll tell you where you can use it. Local area networks, it is possible, but in one local area network it is not possible. Again, you will be logically dividing that local area network into two local area networks, and in one logical local area network you can use the particular IP 10.1 and you can use the same network, same on the another local area network, but there are some restrictions and all those things in order to do that. Okay, that we'll be discussing. Okay, so first, whenever you have given the IP, it will generate gratuitous R request. Okay. Yesterday we have seen the ARP request. Right? There is no pretty much difference between the gratuitous ARP request and normal ARP request. Okay. The only difference is, in the gratuitous ARP request, so this will be the packet. The yellow one will be the normal packet or normal ARP request, and the red or this brown, this red one will be the gratuitous ARP request. Okay, now I'll tell you the difference. Here, source IP is 10.0.0.1, which is normal IP. If he wants to communicate with, it's a source MAC. Well, suppose let us take it as A. Destination MAC, destination IP is 10.0.0.2.3, whatever the IP he wants to communicate with, and destination MAC is 0.0.0.0.12. This is normal ARP request, right? But in the case of gratuitous ARP, source IP is 10.0.0.1 with the IP assigned on him. Source MAC is his own MAC. Destination IP is again the same 10.0.0.1. Why? What is the logic behind this? We'll be discussing. And destination MAC is again 0.0.0.12. Okay, so now what is the purpose, sir? You may ask, why is it having two IPs same? Okay, first the thing is, why are we using gratuitous ARP? To check whether any other devices are having same IP as mine, right? When this ARP request has been broadcasted, this will also be broadcasted. Gratuitous ARP request will also be broadcasted. Okay, when it is broadcasted, every device in the network will get that ARP request. They'll open the packet and they will check, yes, this is an ARP request. They will check the IP. Destination IP. What is the destination IP? 10.0.0.1. Okay. if any of the devices are having the same 10.0.0.1 as their IP, they will immediately reply back. If our device is receiving the ARP reply,
sender.
Obviously, the devices will receive the ARP request. And if any of the devices is having that IP on him, then obviously he will be replying back. Whenever our device who has sent the gratuitous ARP request, if he receives a reply for that ARP request, he will say IP conflict. IP conflict, and I will not accept this IP. Okay. This is the procedure how device will come to know that this IP has been assigned on any other device. Okay. Okay, guys, have you got it?
Reply me.
Okay, yes. So I hope you got this concept. If you have any doubts, you can send me through the chat. Okay, so that is a gratuitous ARP. So this is how the devices will come to know, or they will, this is how the devices will check the duplicacy of the IP. Okay.
The router will not check the duplicacy.
Every device will check it.
Every device
means PC, laptop, mobile, switch, router, everyone will check it.
How do sender accept or get the message? If the router will occur the error, then how will accept the message?
Here again the thing is, when you are, see, suppose this is the case. Okay, according to your example, we have router. Is a router. Now somewhere it is connected to switch and it is connected to PC. Okay, now this router and this PC are having the same IP, right? So now the thing matters is on which device you have given the IP first. Okay, for suppose I have given IP on the router first. On this interface, I have given the IP 10.0.0.1. Okay. After some time, I have given the same IP on the PC. 10.0.0.1. Now, before you are giving this IP on the PC, whenever you have given the IP on this interface, on the router's interface, router will generate a gratuitous ARP.
It can generate,
but that will depend again on in some scenarios. Okay, so whenever you have given assigned the IP on router's interface, it will generate a gratuitous ARP towards that network. First, that is the thing. Whatever the point of time you are assigning an IP, it will generate a gratuitous ARP. Okay. Now it will broadcast it It will broadcast it. Gratuitous app will be broadcasted. Every device will get it. As no one is having the IP, they will not reply. They will not reply. It will make sure that, yeah, no one is having this IP. I will take this IP. Now you have assigned this IP on this router. After 10 minutes, you have given the same IP on this PC. He will generate the gratuitous app, broadcast it. Everyone will receive it. Similarly, our router will also receive it. Router will also receive it. But it will check. I'm already having this IP. Right? It's been 10 minutes. I'm having this IP. He will reply back. He will reply back. Replying back means that already I am having this IP prior to you. I'm already using this IP. You have got this IP just 2 minutes back, but I got this IP 10 minutes back. I'm already using this. So you don't use this IP. That is the meaning of gratuitous app reply. Okay? क्या बोल रहे दिस इज माई पीसी हाँ सीन क्या आपका आपका सीन आपका सीनारियो
आर
नहीं यार वट एवर द आई पी यू टाइप ऑन द गूगल डॉट कॉम ओके सी एक्चुअली नो हाउ विल यू टाइप एन आई पी ऑन द गूगल डॉट कॉम
A system
has an IP address. Okay, system has an IP address. For suppose I have my laptop, it has an IP 192.168.10.1.
And the same IP generator on
another PC. Yes, you have given. See, IP will not be generated. It will be assigned. Network admin will give that IP. It will never be generated. Okay, IPs are never generated. Guys, don't get confused here. IPs will never be generated. They will be assigned on the PC by network admin. Okay. Or we have some protocols which automatically they will give the IP to the device. Okay. DHCP. It is an application layer protocol. Layer 1, layer 7 protocol. DHCP. Dynamic. Host configuration protocol. Dynamic host configuration protocol. Okay. The purpose of DHCP is to automatically assign the IP on the device. Automatically. Okay. For that, what will you do is you will create a server which we call it as DHCP server. You'll create a DHCP server. And whatever the number of devices are there in the network, all will be connected to that DHCP server. Okay. And on the PC, you will have the option whether to get the IP automatically from the DHCP server or to give it manually. Okay. If you have choose the option to automatically get it, it will use DHCP protocol and it will get the IP. From where? From DHCP server. If there is no DHCP server in your local area network, then network admin has to manually assign the IP. Okay? Let me show you that thing. If I go on to my PC, Windows R, ncpa.cpl. Okay, my adapters will be open. And if I go here, any of these, for suppose Ethernet 2, TCP IPv4, this is the, can you see this? Obtain IP address automatically. That means we are telling the PC to get the IP automatically from the DHCP server. Okay. Yes. If you want to give manually, use the following IP address. Now you can give the IP address. 192.168.10.10, whatever you want. Okay. Remember, IP will never be generated by the PC. There are some cases that we'll be discussing. Okay. But for now, either DHCP server or manually it can be assigned. PC will never generate it. Got it? Yep. So this is the gratuitous app. This is how the pieces come to know regarding how this IP conflict has occurred. Okay. Right. So now we'll be seeing the IPv4 addressing. The first thing before this you need to know is, as we have discussed, IP address, it is a logical address, it is a temporary address on the device, which is used to identify that particular device in that network. Okay, right. It is of 24 bits. Oh, sorry, 32 bits. It is of 32 bits or 4 bytes. Okay, dotted decimal is used to represent the IP. Right. So these are some fundamental things you need to know. IP address, whatever the IP address we see, it has been divided into five classes. Class A, Class B, Class C, D, and E. Okay. See here, how many bits do we have in one octet?
Octet.
8 bits. 8 bits, right? 128, 64, 32, 16, 8, 4, 2, and 1. Okay. The maximum value you can get with these 8 bits is 256 values. How? I will make all them as zeros. Zero. One, and all these are zeros. One. This one is 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, all them are zeros. At 2 place it is 1, so value is 2. 3, 1, 1, all these are zeros. 3. Like this, with 8 bits, you can form 256 combinations. 256 combinations. Okay. And in our computer language, always value starts from 0 and goes till the end. 256 means the first value starts from 0 and goes till 255. Goes till 255. Is this clear? Right, that is clear. Now we have dot, right? 8 bits, 8 bits. My value will be ranging from 0 to 255. 0 to 255. 0 to 255. 0 to 255. Now my eyepiece can go from 0.0.0.0 to 255.255.255.255. These many combinations are possible. Okay. And how many total number of combinations or IPs can be possible are total 32 bits, right? 2 power 32 bits. That is around 4.29 billions. Anyone may ask you, total how many number of IPs are possible? 4.29 billions of IPs are present. Okay, you may think that 4.29 billions, okay, but 4.29 billions are not enough. Okay, so the total count is 4.29 billions. Okay, now we'll be discussing about the classes. If we speak about the classes, class A, remember these classes, from where to where they range from. Each and every class you need to remember at any cost as part of CCNA. Okay, once you start IP addressing, these are very much important classes. What are the classes? Where do they range from? 2 to 2. They range to 0.0.0.2 from 127.255.255.255. That is class B, class A, class D, class C. Okay.
127.255.
Yeah. Class A range from 0.0.0.0 to 127.255.255.255.
While starting from 128, sir, in class B.
Understood?
Yeah.
Yes. So they, how, from where they start and where they end, each and every class you need to remember at any cost. What will you do? That is your headache. Okay. Right. So class A starts from 0.0.0.0 to 127.255.255.255. Okay. Class A. Class B, from 128.0.0.0 to 191.255.255.255. Class B. Class C, 192.0.0.0 to 223.255.255.255. 224, 239, 255, 255, 255, 240, 255, 255, 255. Okay. Now the thing is, on what basis did they classify these classes? On what basis did they classify these classes? Okay. Logic, samajh mein aa raha hai? Logic is, on what basis did they classify this? Aba main bol nahi sakte na. We cannot tell. Class A ranges from 0.0.0 to 127.255.255.255. There should be a logic, right? That logic we call it as first octet rule. Okay, first octet rule. Remember, yeah, guys, this rule is very much important. Okay, but no one will ask you, but you should remember this in order to understand the logic. Okay, yeah. First octet rule. According to first octet rule, we have four octets right? 1, 2, 3, and 4. This is the reference they have taken to divide all the IP address into classes. Okay, the left one for you. On that basis, they have decided or they have classified IP addresses into classes. Okay, on what octet? First octet. Which is the first octet for you? That leftmost one for you. Okay, right. Now, if we go 128. 64, 32, 16, 8, 4, 2, 1. So in the class B, sir, in the place of 1.2, I can write 64. No. Class A. It is sort of, but it is not like that. Okay? Class A. Class A. Whatever the class A IP you take, the 128 bit will be 0. 128 bit will be 0. Okay. And remaining bits, whether it is 1 or 0, whether it is 1 or 0, it will come under class A. Will come under class A.
But left one is always 0.
Last 128th bit is 0.
Always.
Always. Or else see like this. In order to make you understand, I'll go through this. So what I'm trying to tell you is, right? Okay. You will be having like this: 128, 64, 32, 16, right? 8, 4, 2. 1. This is your first octet. Dot dot. This is your first octet. Everything is dependent on this first octet. Remaining these three octets, we will not take any care. Okay. Now for class A, 128th bit will be 0, and these values from this 64 till this end, and under second octet, third octet, fourth octet, whatever the value will be, whether it is 1 or 0, it will come under class. Okay. Now if you keep all zeros, your IP will be. Now you are keeping all zeros, your IP will be 0.0.0.0. Except this 128th bit, if you are keeping all these 31 bits, these 7 bits, these 8 bits, these 8 bits, these 8 bits, all these 31 bits, you are keeping them as 1, then your value will be 127.255.255.25. Understood? How? Yeah. Wait, I made this 128 as 1. 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. 1 means that you should add that values. You should add that values. Okay. 128 plus 64 plus 32 plus 16 plus 8 plus 4 plus 2 plus 1. Why? Because all are 1s. If any 1 is 0, I will omit that value. I will omit that value. Okay. Now, if I add from 128 to 1, value will be 255. Value will be 255. Okay. But here in this, I am keeping this as 0. And I am making all this as 1s. Then 64 plus 32 plus 16 plus 8 plus 4 plus 2 plus 1. Value will be 127. And all these are 1s, 255. All these are 1s, 255. All these are 1s, 255. Are you able to get the logic? This is the logic. Okay. So your value starts from all zeros to all ones, except this 128th bit. Except this 128th bit. Example here. See, if I take, what will you understand here? See, if I take a class A range IP, for suppose 10.0.0.10. This is a class A IP. Class A range IP. Okay. Now divide this 10.0.0.10 into binary.
Binary.
10 will be 128th bit will be 0, 64 will be 0, 32, 16, 8th bit will be 1, 4 will be 0, 2 bit will be 1, 0. Dot. 8 bits finish in first octet. 0, everything will be 0. 0, again everything will be 0. Again 10. 0001010. This IP will be 0 at any cost. Class A range, if you are taking a class A range, this will be 0 at any cost. Okay. This is the class A. Class A understood?
Yep.
For class B, 128th bit will be 1, 64th bit will be 0. Then remaining whatever this combination would be, it will come under class B. It will come under class B. Okay. Now if you take whatever the IP you take, for suppose, one eighty dot zero dot zero dot ten. This is a class B range IP. Class B range IP. Okay. Does it come under 128 to 191? This is class B range. Now if I convert this into binary, 128th bit will be 1. Okay. 180, and you can see here the value is 1011100. Okay, and if you see here, last two are 1 and 0. Last two are 1 and 0. For suppose I will try one more. It is not 191. One thirty one, one and zero, one forty, one and zero, one and zero, 150, 10. First two bits will be 10 at any cost. For yes, 180, 1011. 0100.0000000000000000 till here it is finished. 10 0000 1010. These two for all the class B IPs will be 190 at any cost. If it is changing, class will be changed. If any one of this is changing, class will be changed. Understood? For class C, 110. And remaining whatever it could be, it will be forming a class C IP range. Class D, 110. Class E, 1111, and remaining whatever it could be, it will form the class E range. This is called as first octet rule. First octet rule. Okay, the first octet rule is the base to divide the all IP addresses into different classes. Different classes. First octet rule. Okay. After going home, just Google it. First octet rule. You will be having plenty of documents. Okay. You can use whatever the, we can read whatever the thing. Okay. But my suggestion is read the Cisco document. You will have a Cisco document on first octet rule. Go through that document. Understood? Save. So this is the first octet rule. Understood? So in order to divide the classes, we use first octet. That is the logic. So these are the IP addresses and their classes. Okay. Now along with this class IP addresses. Okay, so this will be the IP addresses and their classes. Okay, whatever the IP you assign on a PC, it needs subnet mask. It needs subnet mask. Subnet mask. Let me tell you. Just the relationship between a IP and subnet mask. Okay, it is like a married relationship. A husband cannot be with wife, a wife cannot be with husband. The same thing here. A IP cannot be without a subnet mask, and a without a subnet mask, or a subnet mask cannot be without an IP. Okay, you have given an IP on a PC, you have not given the subnet mask. PC will never accept that IP. Any of the device you take, any of the device you take, they will not accept the IP without subnet. Okay. Question. What is the logic? What is the logic? Why there is no subnet mask? What is the need of subnet mask when we are assigning an IP on the device? Your mind mein question to aata hai. Yeah, husband and wife, there is an answer. They should be living together. Now, what is the relationship between the IP and subnet mask? Why they should stay together? Yeah, as of now. Okay. So IP is used to identify the device in the network. IP is used to identify the device in the network. Subnet mask is used to identify whether that device is in that network or not. Okay. See here, as time has grown, when the IP was initiated, when the concept of IPv4 IP has come, at that point of time, we were having some default subnet mask. Okay, but as the time has grown and as the technology has grown, IPs are not sufficient. The IPs we are having now, they are not sufficient. To reduce that wastage, that we'll be seeing, to reduce the wastage, we have come up with one solution, a temporary solution called subnet. So what happened when I subnetted? What did I do? A big network, I have divided it into two different networks. This is my big network. This network, I have divided it into two different subnets. Okay. On a wall, if I see 192.168.1.0, not 1.10, this will come under this big network. For example, I have taken one IP. Before subnetting, it is under this big network. But after subnetting, how will I know under which subnet will this IP will come? Under this network or under this network? How will I know? Okay, that I can know using the subnet. Actually, 192.168.1.10 is an IP. Okay. Now my network is 192.168.1.0. This is my network. This is my network, complete big network. I have divided that big network into small networks. Small networks. When I divided this big network into small networks, how will I know that this IP will come under which network? Okay, are you getting it? With this subnet mask. With this subnet mask. So that is why whenever you are giving an IP, you must always mention the subnet mask. With this subnet mask, every device can be identified whether is this in my network or out of the network. This can be identified using the subnet mask. Okay. Understood, that is a subnet mask. Okay. Technically, if we speak, it is again a 32-bit number. The same to IP, how we have IP 192.168.1.10, 1.20, 1.30, 1.40, whatever we have. We have four octets, right? Similarly, we'll be having the subnet mask divided into four octets. Okay. So how does that number have all that we'll be seeing? Okay. But for now, it is an 32-bit number helps device find the network part and host part. See here, whenever we take an IP, it will have two parts. IP will have network part plus host part. Now the thing is, what is the difference between this network part and this host part? Okay, network part in a network will never change. In a network, see, I have 100 pieces in my network. 100 pieces. If I want all of them to be in a single network, for all those 100 pieces, whatever the IP I assign, for all those 100 IPs, the network part will be same. Will be same. But host part will be unique. Will be unique. Will be unique. Okay. Now the thing is, this is the network and network part and host part. Okay. Now here, you are human, I am human. We are humans. By seeing on it, we are intelligent. We have invented computers. We are intelligent. We know up to this part. Why? Because we are assigning, we will know that this is the network part and this is the host part. But that is a machine. That is a machine. It doesn't have idea what is a network part and what is an host part. Right? Are you getting it? In order to tell machine that out of this complete IP, out of this complete 32 bits, how many bits are network bits and how many bits are host bits. In order to tell this information, we will use subnet mask. We will use subnet. Any doubts? Any doubts? Now, how this subnet mask will tell how many bits are network bits and how many bits are host bits? Yeah, I'm 5 minutes se yahi baat kar raha hai. It will tell, it will tell, it will tell, it will tell. Logic is how it will tell. How it will tell. My IP has 32 bits. My IP has 32 bits, right? Okay. Bore again, 192, 168, 192, 168. Fancy number like that. 32 bits. 100 dot, 100 dot, 100 dot, 100. Okay. For example, this is an IP. Okay. Now, in this, how many bits are network bits? How many bits are host bits? How subnet mask will tell the device is, /24, which means that, yeah, 8 bits. Count is 32. This 24 value starts from your left. Your left. It starts from here till 1, 2, 3, 4, go till 24. Stop there. These bits are network bits. These bits are network bits. And these bits are same. These 24 bits are same on whatever the IPs you have configured in single network. Okay. Understood. And this is host. This is host part. Okay. This is one type of representation of subnet. Okay. Hundred dot. This is my IP. Earlier I have given /24, or else I can write like this also. 100 dot 100 dot 100 dot 100. Now you may ask question, sir, I have never given /24. I will never mention /24 on my PC, right? Actually, 255 dot 255 dot 255 dot 255 means 8 bits are ones. Then only you are able to get the value 255. CR. 128, 64, 32, 16, 8, 4, 2, 1. Right? If I make all these as ones, then only I will be getting the value 255, right? Then only I'll be getting the value 255. Okay. So slash 24, make 32 bits line 1 to 32. All the bits tick 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 tick, and whatever the number slash 24 till 24 bits, or keep all bits as 1. Divide them into 8 8 8 8. 8 ones it will become 255. 8 ones it will become 255. 8 ones it will become 255. Remaining 8 bits 0. Okay. So subnet mask, if a PC in a subnet mask, if it will find 1, it will consider that bit as network bit. Are you able to get it? In subnet mask, if the device is finding 1, that particular bit in the IP is network bit. Okay, this is the subnet mask. Okay. IP will tell who is the device, and subnet mask will tell whether that device is in the network or not. Okay. Yare dekho, Amitabh Bachchan. See, Amitabh Bachchan. Abhishek Bachchan. Everyone knows Abhishek Bachchan because of Amitabh Bachchan. Okay. Abhishek Bachchan is the IP. Amitabh Bachchan is the subnet mask. Right? Okay. अब डिस्कस करेंगे जया बच्चन ऐश्वर्या राय बच्चन ठीक है ये सारे हम एक ही फैमिली वी आर टेलिंग दिस ऑल बिलोंग्स टू सिंगल फैमिली व्हाई बिकॉज़ एट द एंड दे आर हैविंग बच्चन बच्चन इज अ सबनेट ठीक है डिफॉल्ट सबनेट मास्क डिफॉल्ट सबनेट मास्क एज वी हैव डिस्कस्ड जस्ट नाउ क्लास ए Class B, Class C. Class A has one default subnet mask. Class B has one default subnet mask. Class C has one default subnet mask. Class A slash 8 or 255.0.0.0. Okay. Class B 255.255.0.0 or slash 16. And Class C 255.255.0/24. Okay, this means that if you are taking a class A network, whatever the class A network you take, by default, remember I am telling the word default. By default, if you are taking a class A IP, I'll take in this 10.0.0.2. By default, these values will not be changing. That values will not be changing. This value may vary, may not vary. That is another issue. By default, these values will not vary. That is the meaning of this subnet mask. This means that this is network part. If this is, this itself is changing, network is changing. Network is changing. Okay. And same with class B, class. Okay. And whatever the class A IP you take, and if it is having the subnet mask as slash 8 or 255.0.0.0, then we call it as class full network. Class full network. Class full network. ये देखो यहाँ पे class full network. Okay. Which means that we have not divided that big network into any small networks. Okay, actually we have two types of networks. One is class full network regarding the IPs, class full network, and the class less network. Class full network means it is a class, it is a full network, it is not subnetted. If a class full network, it has been subnetted, then these two networks, whichever the child networks we got, we call it as class less network. classless network. Okay. यार ये देखो बच्चन फैमिली है, ठीक है, पूरा बच्चन फैमिली एक ही घर में रहते हैं, क्लासफुल नेटवर्क है, ठीक है। अब अमिताभ बच्चन का फैमिली एक हो गया और अभिषेक बच्चन का मैरिज हो गया और वो भी अलग घर ले लिया, क्लासलेस नेटवर्क, क्लासलेस, ठीक है। अब बात आती है पब्लिक एंड प्राइवेट, पब्लिक एंड प्राइवेट। यार मेरा एक क्वेश्चन, आपको इंटरनेट चाहिए, ठीक है, यू विल गो टू आईएसपी सर्विस प्रोवाइडर, ठीक है, जो भी एक्साइटल, टेलनेट, जो भी कुछ है। अब आप उनके, उन लोगों के पास जाते हो और अब एक क्वेश्चन पूछते हो, भाई मुझे इंटरनेट कनेक्शन चाहिए, इंटरनेट कनेक्शन चाहिए, ठीक है। वो घर आएगा, एक राउटर फिक्स करेगा, छोड़े, he will leave, he will leave. Once you have gone to an internet service provider and you have asked him, bro, please give me the internet connection. You will pay him some money. He will give you the router, wireless adapter, जो भी अपना technical language में आप बात कर सकते हो. He will give you a wire connected to his point and he will tell you are connected to the internet. पता एक्चुअली क्या हो रहा है पीछे, फ्रॉम फ्रंट एंड यू आर एबल टू सी अ वायरलेस एक्सेस पॉइंट, केबल एंड केबल इनसाइड योर पोर्ट, ये होता है इंटरनेट कनेक्शन भाई, ये होता है इंटरनेट कनेक्शन, नहीं, ठीक है। व्हाट एक्चुअली हैपनिंग इज व्हेन ही कम्स टू योर होम ही विल कॉन्फिगर समथिंग ऑन योर वायरलेस अडैप्टर. The actual why are you paying the money to him is you are actually taking a public IP on rent. On rent. Okay. Now the thing is, sir, why should I take a public IP? Without that, can't I speak to internet? Impossible. Why? एक ही बात है, impossible. ठीक है. The whatever the data you are sending. Whenever it is going out of your network, it will be adding that public network. इसके पीछे लगा के भेज देता है, ठीक है। दुनिया में कोई भी डिवाइस इसको देखेगा, उसको पता चलेगा, हाँ भाई ये तो एक आईपी है, हमारा पब्लिक आईपी है, ठीक है, ये जिंदा, ठीक है। Now the thing is, why have we divided into public and private? Public and private. Yeah, how many companies do you have? According to our idea, how many companies we have? Okay, TCS, Google, Microsoft. Okay, in every such a small number of companies we have spoken, these companies itself, they have some millions of pieces. Some millions of pieces, devices, routers, firewalls, LTM, load balancers, all these devices. Har ek device ke liye IP to chahiye. हर एक डिवाइस के लिए एक आईपी चाहिए ही चाहिए. एवरी डिवाइस विल नीड एन आईपी अंटिल एंड अनलेस इट कैन नॉट स्पीक टू वन अनदर, राइट? इफ दिस कंपनीज इटसेल्फ हैविंग दिस मेनी डिवाइसेस एंड इफ दिस कंपनीज इटसेल्फ आर टेकिंग ऑल द आईपीस, व्हाट अबाउट द रिमेनिंग पब्लिक? व्हाट अबाउट द रिमेनिंग पब्लिक? ओके, कीपिंग दिस as an issue in mind, the IANA, whichever the organization takes care of all these numbers, they have thought this problem. Wo intelligent log hai, tabhi usko pata chala, ha bhai kabhi bhi ye problem aa sakta hai. Okay, so they have taken this problem into consideration and they have divided IPs into two categories. One is public IP, other is private IP. Okay, now the public IP is, it will be unique all over the world. It will be unique all over the world. Duniya mein kahan bhi jaoge, you will have, you rented a public IP. You will be having one IP, and wherever you go in the world, you will never find that IP. You only will be having that IP. Okay, and we will have private IP addresses. ठीक है, अब यहाँ पे बैठा है, ठीक है, आपके सामने वाली बिल्डिंग है ना, इसके अंदर घुस के जाओ ये आईपी होगी वहां होगी ही होगी बिना कम्युनिकेशन हो नहीं पाएगा ठीक है सो दैट इज द थिंग ओके ग्लोबल आईपी एड्रेसेस आर लाइक यूनिक ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड that are exclusively for public communication okay and if you want to speak if you want to make communication possible for your own services in your local area network IANA has given you one solution you can use your private IP addresses okay private IP addresses can be repeated okay for suppose you are having 192.168.1.0.1.1.2.3.4 okay and the same network can be used by your neighbor also okay so how they will be communicating you are telling that this is a private network that is a public network we are actually having if you see in our home if you open your phone and if you see obviously you will be having the private network private ip अभी तो मैंने बोला पब्लिक प्राइवेट आईपी कभी भी पब्लिक से बात नहीं करता है ना कम्युनिकेशन कैसे होता है ठीक है ये कुछ होता है बड़े वाले ठीक है अब तो हम छोटे छोटे बच्चे हैं ठीक है जब हम बड़े वाले होंगे तब बात करेंगे ठीक है सो दैट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन ग्लोबल आईपी एड्रेसेस एंड सॉरी ग्लोबल पब्लिक आईपी एड्रेसेस एंड प्राइवेट आईपी ओके एंड इफ यू वांट टू रीड सम डेफिनेशंस यू कैन रीड इट ग्लोबल आईपी एड्रेसेस दैट आर लीज्ड to corporations by ISP are called public IP addresses okay and these are routable in the public network and IP addresses that are unregistered and can be used by any company for their internal communication are called private IP addresses okay and these are not globally routable yaar aa gaya yaar hamare bade bhai okay so here we are having internet assigned numbers authority main frankly baat kar raha hu main mujhe iska full form abhi tak pata nahi theek hai kyunki jitne bhi hum baat karte hai na IANA bolte theek hai so internet assigned numbers authority okay this is the organization or group of people who will maintain numbers not only ip addresses but we as we discussed we have many other numbers like port numbers as numbers that we'll be seeing as we go as numbers okay this whatever the numbers are there regarding networking all these are handled by IANA okay these are the main people okay so what do they do is if you request a public ip where will you go if you want internet connection you will be going for the ISP service provider okay so what will he do is he will assign you a public ip or he will rent you a public ip okay very easy getting the public ip stream he will be getting that public ips from regional registry okay regional registry is again a local body which is again a local body ठीक है क्या होता है भाई आपको कुछ काम है you have some work okay you need to get some गरीब लोग है यार मैं तो गरीब हूँ ठीक है मुझे कुछ क्या चाहिए स्कॉलरशिप चाहिए ठीक है मैं क्या सीधा सीएम के पास जाऊंगा मैं मार लेगा है ना why because it is a very small issue cm will not take any care I will go to my college principal or educational officer the regional educational officer whoever I okay same way ISP service provider will go to regional registry okay now how my educational officer will go to the government and will get my work done similarly regional registry will go and request IPs from I understood this is general flow of public ips private ips ka kuch flow hota nahi theek hai apna marzi beer peena pe lo theek hai lekin ghar mein pata hona hai theek hai tab hum to decent hote यही होगा. ओके, प्राइवेट आईपी एड्रेसेस, प्राइवेट आईपी एड्रेसेस आर अप टू यू, वॉट एवर यू वॉन्ट यू कैन डू इट, बट पब्लिक आईपीस ऑलवेज यू हैव टू गो टू आईएसपी. सर्विस प्रोवाइडर विल गो टू रीजनल रजिस्ट्री एंड रीजनल रजिस्ट्री विल गो फॉर द आईआर. ओके, एंड वी हैव सम रूल्स इन इट. ओके, what the thing is, IANA will also not give the IP address as soon as you go and ask them. Okay, they will think. Why? Because दुनिया में सबसे महंगा वाले कुछ है networking में, by वो IP. IPs. IPs are the very costliest and the very deficient objects in terms of network. Okay, so what do they do is, they will think, whenever you keep a request, they will think, does this guy need this IPs really or not? If he is thinking, yes, he needs it, then they will release some IPs. If not, they will not. If not, they will not. So this is some flow of IPs. Okay. So this is some American registry. This is African registry. This is London registry. This is Asian registry. By I don't know what it is. Okay, so if you want to read regarding them, you will have this IANA.org, which is a official website of IANA. You can go through that website once and you can read that. You can do a lot of research. Okay, right. Okay, private IP addresses. Okay, so as we discussed, class A ranges from 0.0.0.0 to 127.255.255.255. Okay, from here to here, in between, omit this range. Omit this range. Okay, and remaining are public IPs, and we have some registered or reserved IP ranges. Okay, for some particular purposes that we will see it. Okay, but excluding this registered, reserved, whatever the IP addresses and private IP addresses, remaining all IP addresses are public IP addresses. Remaining all are public IP addresses. Yes, these are private IP addresses. This is not reserved. Everyone can use that anyway. These are not reserved. These are kept aside for public, for private purposes. Okay? Right. Understood? In class B, 172.16.0.0 to 172.31.255.255. This range of IP addresses are private IP addresses at class B range. At class B range. And if you go to class C, 0.0 to 255.255. This range of IP addresses are kept aside. Other than this, whatever IP addresses you have, they are reserved. I mean, they are for public purposes. Okay. D and E. इसको क्या हो गया? बेचारा ये से इसको क्या हो गया? Okay. Class D is used for multicasting. Used for multicasting. Okay. Multicaching is a very big topic. Neither you will read in CCNA nor in CCMP. That you will be doing completely at CCI. Okay, but you will be having some basic multicast addresses that will be coming under different routing protocols. Okay, so like this, this complete D range is kept aside for one particular purpose: multicasting. Multicasting. Okay, and E, it has been kept aside. Okay, not for public use, not for multicasting. It is for complete other purpose. Okay, it is for research and development. Okay, For that purpose, they are kept as class E range. Okay. So literally, what do we use? The range of IP addresses that public use is class A, B, and C. In that, for private area, for private usage, we will use private IP address ranges, and for public usage, for internet, for all these purpose, we will use public IP addresses. Okay, understood? Right. Thank you. Yo. So public IP addresses, they should be purchased and usually used in the internet edge. Okay, so usually you will be receiving only one IP. Okay, if you want multiple IPs, you can able to get them. That is not a big deal. Okay, but where do we use this? Is after three layers: access layer, distribution layer, core layer, and above the core layer, we'll be having one more layer, that is edge layer. That is edge layer. Okay, the devices at the edge layer will be directly connected to the ISP. Okay, and edge routers, edge firewalls, whatever. Okay, and that devices, they will be having this public IP address. Okay, and the range of public IP addresses, excluding the private IP addresses, whatever we have, that is public IP address. Okay, now reserve. These are reserved. 0.0.0.0. Okay. 0. Range is kept aside for default routes. Default routes for default routing. Okay. For this purpose, we have kept this aside. For now, just remember why have we kept this aside? That is for default routing. Okay. When we are doing the routing, we will discuss what is completely deeply what is default. Okay, next, loopbacks. In the class A, we have 0.0.0.0 to 127.255.255.255. Okay, you cannot allocate on your PC. On your PC, you cannot allocate this range and this range. It will never allow you. It will never allow you. Okay. Why? Because this is kept aside for default routing and this is kept aside for loopbacks. Okay. See, if you want to check your health of your PC, if all the NICs they are working fine or not, okay, what will you do? We cannot open our laptop, right? We'll be having warranties. Duniya mein kuch hai bhai, bahut sara business chal raha hai. Okay. If you remove your laptop and if you open your back cover, warranty will be expired and all these things. Okay. So these people, they have thought this and they have given a simple solution, that is ping on 127.001.002, whatever you want, 127 range IPs. Okay, that will tell you whether all are working fine or not. Okay, so these are loopbacks, okay, which are for internal purpose of your devices. Internal purposes of your devices. That's nothing much more than. Okay, and a PIPA. Automatic private IP addresses, address range, ATIPA, a PIPA. Okay, so we haven't discussed this, but just now I have told you that you can tell PC to directly get the IP from DHCP server. Okay, for some XYZ reasons, DHCP server is not responding. DHCP server is not responding. Okay, at that point of time, our PC, especially Windows, Microsoft, they have reserved this range. I don't know why that particularity for Windows. Okay, but Windows, Microsoft has kept this range as such. If you are opening your Microsoft Windows, and if you have assigned, you have told your PC to directly get the IP from DHCP, and if your DHCP server is not responding, at that point of time, your PC will itself assign an IP for himself. He will himself assign an IP. From which range? That is from a PIPA range. It ranges from 169.254.0.02 169.254.255.255. These range of IP addresses. It may pick anyone from this. So when DHCP server is not working fine, or if the DHCP server is not giving you the IP, our system will automatically assign an IP for himself. That is from IP bar. That is from IP bar range. Okay. This is some configuration. How do we configure a router with an IP? Okay. Just you have to go to interface configuration mode, give the command IP address, and then you have to give the IP, whatever you want to give to that device, and also subnet mask. If you are not giving the subnet mask, it will not accept the IP. It will not accept the IP. Okay. And if you want to verify that whatever configuration you have done, for suppose you have given the IP, and if you want to check whether this IP is working fine or if that device is has accepted that IP or not, show interface, or else you can type show IP interface brief, which will tell you on what interface have you given this IP. Okay. Or we have many other purposes, we'll be discussing them. I have already shown you this yesterday, right? So if you want to see what are the IPs assigned on your adapters and ICs on your Windows machine, then you can give this command. Here it should be some little different. Here you should have space. ipconfig /all. Okay. I'll just show you here. ipconfig /all. This will show you all the IPs. Okay. So whatever the adapters you have, logical adapters, physical adapters, whatever the IPs are assigned on them, along with their MAC addresses, physical addresses, everything you can see with this command, ipconfig /all. Okay. On your Windows machine. Okay. But if you are going to Linux, okay, there you can give if config. It is not IP, it will be if config. Okay, that's it. Yaar, aajkal mujhe Linux bhi aa raha hai. Baad aati hai subnetting. Okay, just we'll discuss why are we doing subnetting and all this. Okay, tomorrow we'll be discussing complete subnetting. Okay. Subnetting. We are very intelligent guys. We know subnetting. Okay. By which you can get some idea what is this actually means. Okay, sub is actually if you are having a big something, whatever the thing. Okay, and if you have divided that into many pieces or half or whatever thing you have divided, and that half part we call it as sub, whatever the thing you want to add, you can add. Sub means a part of that something, whole thing. Okay. And here in this networking, subnetting is dividing a class full network into classless networks. Okay. See, your definition though very good hai, dividing classful networks into classless networks. Okay, the thing is, sir, why to divide? What is the purpose of dividing? When we are having this many of IPs, we can use the one we want, and whatever we are not having, we'll keep them aside for future use. Yeah, we are Indians. Yeah, Indians, so we'll have very front forward view. Okay, you can tell that. But the thing is, whatever the IPs we have, they are the most deficient ones. Again. Okay, so IPs are deficient. I don't know in Hindi what we call deficient. Matlab, shortage. Very shortage. We have very shortage of IPs. Okay, so in order to avoid this problem, in order to avoid this shortage of IPs, we use subnetting. How? See here, you have a requirement. You have a requirement. For suppose you are having around 50 pieces in your network. 50 pieces in your network. Obviously, we need 50 IPs on the 50 devices. Okay. So, by default, if you have taken a classful network, very good number, 192.168.1.0/24. Now the thing is, host part, last part, last octet is completely left aside. Why? Because why am I telling is subnet mask is /24/24, which means that 24 bits are network part, network bits, and remaining 8 bits are host bits. That means whatever the IPs are formed with that 8 bits, I can use uniquely between the pieces. Understood? Now 8 bits means 256 IPs. How many IPs do I want? 50 IPs. I am having 256 IPs. Okay. What is the purpose of extra 200 IPs? Okay. Or you take a scenario like this. You might be thinking this is okay, but take a scenario like this. You have 50 pieces and 50 pieces. Overall, you have 100 pieces. Okay. But the requirement is 50 pieces should be in one network, and the 50 other pieces should be in one network. Obviously, we need two networks. Then I'll be using here 192.168.1.0/24 network, and here 192.168.2.0/24 network. Problem solved. Asli kahani samne hai bhai. It is having 256 IPs, but we need only 50 IPs. Remaining 200 IPs, they are wastage. And here also 200 IPs, they are waste. Good for nothing. 200 here, 200 here, 400 IPs. Government ki tarah ho gaye. Hai na? If government needs 50,000 crores to run the government, they will take 2 lakhs debt from the World Bank or from Reserve Bank. यही कहानी यहाँ पे भी चल रहा है. ओके, बट नेटवर्क इंजीनियर्स आर द मोस्ट एफिशिएंट इंजीनियर्स, राइट? ओके, सो व्हाट डू दे डू इज दे हैव वन सॉल्यूशन. व्हाटएवर द नेटवर्क आई हैव 192.168.1.0/24 नेटवर्क, 215 6 IPs. I will divide this complete network into subnetworks. Okay. By that, what will I do is,
sir.
Oh, bro. Hey, bro. You there?
Yeah.
How are you?
Hi.
Oh.
I want to ask a question.
Yeah.
I don't get about that /24.
1.0/24. Huh. Yeah. Mm. What's the question? Why did they take this slash 24?
Yeah.
How much time have you been in the video? Oh, it's been 5 minutes.
Yeah.
All right. I can think. Okay. So 192.168.1.0 is actually, it is a class C IP.
Yeah.
It is a class C IP. Okay. So once go through the video after the class. Okay. So it is a class C IP. Okay. So class C IPs. Okay. Every class will have default subnet mask. Default subnet mask. Okay. So class C will have default subnet mask as 255.255.255.0. This is a default subnet mask of class C IPs or slash 24. Both means the same.
As 24 and is both same. Yeah.
Oh, sorry. I didn't get you.
I said this. 0A255.255.255.0
means /24.
Yeah.
Okay. What the thing is, you can either write like this 192.168.1.0/24 or else 192.168.1.0/255.255.255.0. Either of the ways, it is correct.
Yeah.
Understood?
Yeah.
Yes. Why am I discussing that? Or yeah, subnetting. Okay. So what will I do is I will divide 192.168.1.0/24, which is having 256 IPs. 256 IPs. Okay. IP. Yeah. I will divide this into two networks, which is having equal number of IPs. Okay. So it is 256 IPs. So 256 by 2, 120. So every network will receive 128 IPs. 128 IPs. How many IPs do I want? 50 IPs?
50
IPs. Okay. Now, how many IPs will be wasted? 70? 8? 28. Okay. See here, actually, it is an example, but actually, this will not be the scenario. Okay.
Sir,
when we do the subnetting, you will be understanding the efficient subnetting. Yeah, Trisor.
78 is for.
CR, when I divide 256 IPs network into two networks, every network, see, 192.168.1.0, I have divided this into two networks. One is A, other is B.
B.
By default, it is having 256 IPs.
Yeah.
So now, after dividing, A will have 128 IPs and B will have 128 IPs. Okay, are you getting it? Trishore, are you getting it?
Yes, I got.
Yes. So our requirement is 50 IPs in one network and 50 IPs in another network. Okay. So out of 128, I will use 50 and remaining IPs rest are 78. Here also remaining are 78. Okay. So what I'm trying to tell you is, okay, when I do subnetting, wastage will be reduced. Wastage of IPs will be reduced. Okay. Here, if I am not using subnetting, 200 IPs of one network and 200 IPs of one network, overall 400 IPs are wasted. Right? Yes. But if you are doing subnetting for a single network, okay, out of 512 IPs, 400 IPs were wasted when we were not performing subnetting. But when we are doing subnetting here, how many IPs are wasted? 78 here, 78 here. Okay, so wastage is reduced. Okay, so like this, we use subnetting to reduce the wastage of IPs. Reduce the wastage of IPs. Okay, and remember, whatever the IPs you have, 192.168.1.0, it is a class C network. If it is having the same subnet mask as default subnet mask, then it is called classful network. Classful network, which means subnetting is not performed. Subnetting is not performed. Okay. Now I have divided this into two networks, A and B. Now these two are classless networks. Classless networks. Okay, so this is a classful network, this is a classless network. Right?
Yeah.
Yep, so this will be for today, guys. Tomorrow we'll be starting the subnetting. And if God, by the God's grace, if everything is permitting, we will finish it tomorrow itself.
Sir.
Okay, IPv4 subnetting, we'll be finishing it tomorrow. And IPv6, we'll be doing it back when I'll be back. Right? So, right, guys, then see you in the next class. Bye. Sir. Yeah, Tushar.
Even the first class.